Welcome back. In the last video we have discussed the volatile oil and their occurrence in the nature. In this video we will discuss the chemistry of volatile oils. As we know that volatile oils are made up of terpene oils such as mono, sesquidite, tri and tetraterpene by adding of isoprene in each input. Coming to the learning objectives, after viewing this video on chemistry of volatile oil, the student should be able to understand the main chemical compound present in the volatile oil, essential oil, explain the sources of terpenoids and extraction process of volatile oil. Coming to the chemistry of volatile oil, the ingredients found in essential oils are organic due to their molecular structure, which is based on carbon skeleton held together by hydrogen atom. Oxygen and sometimes nitrogen and sulfur atoms are also present in this. Main chemical components found in essential oils are monoterpenes and sesquiterpenes, phenols and alcohols, aldehyde and ketones, ethers and esters. In monoterpenes, as we know, these chemicals are found in most essential oils containing 10 carbon atoms, such as limonene that is present in citrus fruits, such as citrus oil like lemon, pinene, present in pine, camphene, present in camphor. Coming to next category, that is sesquiterpenes, these terpenes are not as volatile as monoterpenes, they contain 15 carbon atoms in it and hence the name sesqui, which means one and half. Example of this sesquiterpenes are gingiberine and caryophyllene. In category of phenols, thymols are used in oils present in clove or comes under volatile oil category. Alcohols like lavendolol, nerol, geranol and xanthol that is present in sandalwood. In the category of aldehydes, cinnamaldehyde, sulfonylol, and in category of ketones, phenol and mesquite that is present in mushrooms. In the category of ethers and ester, mostly present and form after decomposition of ester bond like cinnamyl acetate, allyl isothiocyanate, that is after the hydrogenation of mustard, all these can be formed. Coming to the biosynthesis or origin of triterpenoids. As we know that acetate in the presence of acetyl coenzyme converts to acetoacetyl coenzyme, which combines with HMG-CoA to form beta hydroxy beta methyl glutathione coenzyme, and this in the presence of reductase forms malonic acid, and kinase will act on this by introducing phosphate group. It converts 5-pyrophosphate, 3-phosphomalonic acid, and after decarboxylation, that is removal of carbon dioxide, it converts to isopentyl pyrophosphate, and this isopropyl pyrophosphate is the end product of malonic acid. This combines with another unit of isoprene that forms heliterpenes, and then when two units of IPP combines, it forms monoterpenes, and when IPP further combines with monoterpene, it forms FPP, permethyl pyrophosphate, that is sesquiterpene, with sesquiterpene carbon, and the category is integrin nitrogen. Coming to the extraction process of essential oil, the method used in extraction of essential oil is normally depend on what type of botanical material is being used, like steam distillation, that is called hydro distillation process, means Clevenger apparatus is used at light or small scale, then solvent extraction in flowers, then expiration to filling pipier method, then hypercritical carbon dioxide method. In steam distillation process of essential oil, extraction. The botanical material is placed in a still and steam is formed over the material. The steam forces open the box in which the oil is kept in the plant material, and the molecule of this volatile oil then escape from plant material and evaporate into the steam. The steam which then contains the essential oil is passed through a cooling system to condense the steam, which forms a liquid from which the essential oil and water is then separated. This is the assembly of Clevenger apparatus that is used in laboratory scale isolation of the volatile oil. That in which boiling occurs when the vapor pressure of the liquid is cut by atmospheric pressure. In large scale extraction of essential oils, first our dried botanical are placed in the detroit or steam. In this assembly, you can see this rice steam is introduced in a lower chamber of the reservoir and passed through the botanical ingredients to vaporize the volatile oil in the plant materials. In infinitus method, the extraction of perfumes from flowers by means of air and fat is done. Glass plates is framed or covered with highly purified and odorless vegetable or animal fats, and the petals of the botanical materials are spread across it. The petals remain in this greasy compound for a few days and couple of weeks to allow the essence to disperse into the compound, and depleted petals are removed and replaced with the fresh harvest petals every time. When the mix has reached saturation point, the flowers are removed and the fat and fragrance oils then washed with alcohol to separate the extract from the remaining fat. And this fat may be used for preparation of straw. Coming to the question, which apparatus is used for extraction of essential oil or volatile oil at laboratory scale? Let me pause the video for a minute and try to answer the question. Here the answer. Clevenger apparatus is used for extraction of volatile oils at the laboratory scale. The next method, that is called a cooling method, the fruit is placed in a device and rotated with spikes on the side functioning the oil cells in the skin of the fruit. This causes the oil cells to rupture and the essential oil to come down to the center of the device which contains a collection area. Thank you all. In the next video, we will discuss about the characterization of volatile oil through GCMS method.